This time, I'm going to talk about credit risk modeling in Python. Credit risk refers to the potential loss that a lender or investor may face due to the inability of a borrower to fulfill their financial obligations. In other words, it's the risk that a borrower will default on their loan or credit obligations, leading to a loss of the principal amount or interest payments. Credit risk is a fundamental concept in the world of finance and lending, and managing it effectively is crucial for maintaining the stability and health of financial institutions and markets. Credit risk modeling is a process used by financial institutions and lenders to quantify and assess the potential credit risk associated with lending money or extending credit to borrowers. It involves using statistical and mathematical techniques to predict the likelihood of a borrower defaulting on their financial obligations, such as loan repayments, and to estimate the potential loss that could result from such defaults. In this video, I'm going to use this default of credit client's dataset for credit risk modeling. You can download data from this website. Now, let's go to that website, take a look. Those data descriptions I just copied and pasted here from that website. This is the website where you can download this default or credit card client's dataset. You can click here to download the data. This dataset contains information on default payments, demographic factors, credit data, history of payment, and bill statements of credit card clients in Taiwan from April 2005 to September 2005, and currency is in New Taiwan dollars. You can see first column we have ID for each client, and then we have this limit balance. This is amount of given credit in New Taiwan dollars. And then we have gender here. And then we have education and marriage. Paid zero means repayment status in September 2005. Minus one means paid duly. One means payment delay for 1 month. 2 means payment delay for 2 months, etc. And pay 2 means repayment status in August 2005. I don't know why the pay 1 is missing here. And this is start from pay 0 and jump to pay 2. But this is just a label, it doesn't matter what it's called. Bill amount 1 means amount of bill statement in September 2005. If we come back, this pay 0 means repayment status in September 2005. It looks like this pay 0 should be pay 1. But if you open this CSV file, I download this file and save it as an Excel spreadsheet so I can put some highlights here. but the data is the same with the downloaded CSV. You can see the heading is page zero because I will upload my Python program into my GitHub, and I don't want you face any issue when you run the program with your downloaded data, so I didn't modify this CSV file. You can see this bill amount 1 is September 2005, and then bill amount 2 is in August 2005, so the time is like go backward. And then this one is pay amount 1, means amount of previous payment in September 2005. The last column, default payment next month. If the payment default, it is 1, otherwise it's 0. When we take a look at this data set, you can see we have this bill amount here, bill amount 6, and then the payment will be next month, so will be pay amount 5. So it's not bill amount 6 versus pay amount 6, but it's bill amount 6 versus pay amount 5. And similarly, it's all shift one column between those pay amount and the bill amount. You can see here, if bill amount is 4, then pay amount is 3. Okay, this is the Python program I use to load this CSV file and analyze the data. Again, I've uploaded this program to my GitHub. You can download it, and also you can download the dataset from this website and try it by yourself. First, I will load this data, and then I will take a look at the data about education, marriage, etc., about the distribution, also about the age distribution, and about the gender. And then I will check the default. You can see I break down by marriage status, and then I check the default. And then I'll check the pay amount versus the bill amount. Okay, now let's run the program. You can see I load the data here. This is from this CSV file. You can see over 23,000 clients didn't default, but over 6,600 clients defaulted. And for the age distribution, it looks like this. It looks like the peak is around 30. And about the gender, you can see we have more female than the male. And this is not defaulted, and this is defaulted. And for the education, you can see this is graduate school, this is university, this is high school, and the distribution looks like this. When we check the marriage distribution, the married, this looks like this, and single look like this. From this graph, we can see in Taiwan, somehow married client is easy to default. And this one is limit balance, if you still remember. The limit balance means amount of given credit in New Taiwan dollars. And if we check the bill amount versus pay amount, you can see along this line, this means the client paid the bill amount duly. And similarly with this one, and a lot of people, you see, the bill amount is this one, but the pay amount is this one. So they paid less than the bill amount. And in the meantime, some clients paid more than the bill amount, but fewer people were doing that. You can see this is bill amount 2 versus pay amount 1. And similarly, with different time period, it looks like this. From our data set, we can see it's obviously there are more people who are not defaulted than the defaulted people. This kind of problem is called class imbalance. One class has more data than another class. This kind of issue, we can address it with oversampling technique. In this model, I'm going to use synthetic minority oversampling technique, also called SMOT. SMOT is a popular technique used in machine learning and data mining to address the class imbalance problem in classification tasks. Class imbalance occurs when one class, the minority class, in our case is defaulted class, has significantly fewer examples than another class. In this model, we are dealing with not defaulted class, leading to biased model performance. SMOT is a specific oversampling technique designed to generate synthetic instances for the minority class. Let's say we have class A, we have 900 instances. Class B, we have 100 instances. Obviously, class A has much more instances than class B. So what we are going to do is we are going to generate synthetic B instances so we can increase the instances of class B to 500. So original 100 plus synthetic 400. So we can make them closer and reduce this imbalance problem. In this data set, obviously, we have this imbalance problem because we have much more not defaulted instances than defaulted instances. So we will use our oversampling technique. After we apply this smooth technique, you can see the instances for not defaulted and for defaulted will become the same. Now we finished the preparation and analysis of this data set. This is the data analysis part for credit risk modeling in Python. Next time, I'm going to talk about how to build our credit risk model with this data set. Please provide your comments and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.